Hi, welcome here. Let's see how to apply 2D and 3D text with Cyberlink PowerDirector 13. Please correct us to improve our videos. We will add text on the video, not subtitles or closed captions. These can be added through the subtitle room instead. The text itself, with color, style and font, is inside the text room on the left. The text room collects a few ready templates of text that you can click and drag to add them in your project. But in short, you have two main kinds of text from which you can create any kind of text with or without effects: 2D text and the 3D-like text. You can create your own 2D text going to the sheet icon on top and choosing 2D title. This opens the title designer window used to personalize your text in full. Go to save when you finish. What you save is not a unique text clip. You will save a text template. Text templates have their own text style fixed, so that if you like using it again later, you can simply click and drag it on your project, instead of playing with the title designer every time. So to add your text, just click and drag one of the templates on the timeline. You can choose to add it to a video track or a title track, although the first one gives you much more control. In fact, the title track is always at the bottom and can't be moved, and plus it can't be turned off. Then you can move, stretch or trim the text clip as you like, as we saw in the beginner tutorial. Although it is a visible clip, you don't have any envelope to adjust its opacity level. To set transparency, you must use the title designer. Once the text clips are added in your project, you can edit them singularly, even if they come from the same text template. In fact, once text clips are formed, these become independent, and so you can change their style or color one by one. To start editing, just double-click. The title designer appears, showing your text on the full preview of the video. You can type inside to edit text. Move it by dragging its contours. Scale it with the white nodes. And rotate using the green one. On the left, you can customize the aspect of the text. Use font type to edit sides, font, color, and adjust paragraphs. Font face to adjust the opacity and the blur levels. Reflection, font shadow, and border to add reflection, shadow, and emboss, respectively. You can enable and disable these effects checking the small square. Remember that these settings are applied on the selected text only if you have any. Zoom in and out using the zoom buttons in the top right corner to check how your text is going on. If you prefer to use ready templates instead, just go to character presets. But the text clip is not at all a clip just made of text. The title designer is able to add other objects inside it. If you click on the first icon, you will add another piece of text inside the same text clip. You can edit it as we have just seen. You can use the second one to add particles. The third one to add images from your computer and so on. Use Ctrl and Z or the Undo button to cancel your latest actions. Below the preview, you do have a timeline, so you can set the visibility order by pulling up or down the different rows. The one that is lower is the one that is shown above all others, as seen in the main timeline. To remove any row, and so it's object related, right-click and go to Remove. Each text added in the timeline has a starting and an ending effect that are represented by the darker sides of such row. These effects are used to make the text appear and disappear with motion. Select the title and click on the Motion tab on the left and select any effect to apply on the text. The length of each darker side sets the length of such effect in time. The longer it is, the more the effect will last to make text appear or disappear. These effects do work on text only. Once you are done with all, go to Save below. How about creating 3D text? In this case, you must start from a 3D text-like template. Go to the sheet icon on top and select 3D-like title. Save and drag it inside the timeline to start editing it. This text clip behaves in the same way. If you double-click and observe the title designer window, you see that all is identical, except for some additional features, like the 3D rotation and the textures, which cover all the 3D text in full. You can also change the extrusion level going inside the font face. All these settings are always applied on the full text, even if you selected a part of it. Even after applying these effects, you can type, of course. The text will be put temporary with no 3D rotation, to come back as it was when you finish typing. Use 3D settings to adjust the proper zoom on the text. As seen inside the 2D text, you can apply starting and ending transitions going to motion section. These 3D transitions are available when you use the 3D-like titles. In the title designer, there is also image settings. In case you add an image, you can stretch the darker sides to decide the duration of the fade-in and fade-out offset transitions. Then, you can use image settings to apply advanced effects, like the chroma key. This is used to apply transparency to the image when a color shown on top is matched. So, if you choose black, the image will become transparent where there is black. Then you can play with the bars more at the bottom to set settings better. These are 3D clips added on a timeline where you have to render. You can use a normal standard 2D render with no problems, although it is better to render in 3D. Thanks for watching! Check out our guide for more about Cyberlink PowerDirector 13.